Hi, I'm Caroline from Doodles and Digits. Did you know that there are multiple ways to compare fractions? That's what we're going to learn today. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area symmetry fractions too. It's all here for you.
The first strategy we're going to learn is we're going to actually draw models to help us compare fractions. Let's look at these two fractions here. What do you notice? Which one is greater? That's right. We can actually look at visuals or models to help us compare fractions. Let's try a few more. Let's try these two.
5/8 or 3/4.
That's right. All right, let's look at one more.
3/8 or 1/2.
Yeah. These actually have different denominators, but you can easily see with the visual which one is greater. You can also use a fraction chart to help you compare fractions. Let's look at this fraction chart here. All right, what do you notice about the fraction chart? Let's try comparing two numbers. Which one's larger, 1/2 or 2/5?
By looking at the chart, you can see that 1/2 is greater than 2/5.
All right, let's try another one. Which one's larger, 1/8 or 2/12? Now that we've tried a few together, let's see if you can compare a few on the number chart right now.
2/3 or 4/5? 2/3 is less than 4/5. 4/6 or 10/12? 4/6 is less than 10/12. 5/8 or 3/5? 5/8 is greater than 3/5.
A number line is another great tool to compare fractions. Let's look at a number line.
A number line!
All right, what do you notice? What's going on with this number line? Yeah, you might notice that there's actually a different fraction being shown on the top of the number line than the bottom of the number line. What two fractions are being shown? So when we compare fractions, we can actually place both fractions on this same number line to compare them. Let's try these two fractions. Which one's greater? All right, let's try another one. Let's compare these two fractions with the number line.
2/3 and 3/4. 2/3 is less than 3/4.
All right, now that we've tried a few together, let's see if you can compare a few fractions using a number line on your own.
2/5 and 3/7. 2/5 is less than 3/7. 4/5 and 5/7. 4/5 is greater than 5/7.
The last strategy is you can also use reasoning to compare fractions. So for example, you can actually use benchmark fractions and then just looking and thinking through it to know which one's greater. So for example, if we're looking at these two fractions here, they both have the same denominator. So we can think, what do I know about this? Well, we know if you have the same denominator, it's the same size piece. So whichever one has more pieces is going to be greater. Let's look at this here. You've got 2/5 and 3/5. They both have fifths in the denominator, so we can look at the numerator and know that the 3/5 is greater. Let's try another one. What about 4/8 and 6/8? Since they have the same denominator, we know that the larger numerator is going to be greater. You can also use benchmark fractions like 1/2. So let's say we have these two fractions here. You can think, okay, is this greater than 1/2 or less than 1/2? This one here is greater than 1/2. This one over here is less than 1/2. So we know the one that'll be greater than 1/2 is going to be greater. Review time. What is the greater or less than symbol? This is the greater than symbol, and this is the less than symbol. How can you remember which one's greater than or less than? Some people like to think of the opening as a mouth and eat the bigger number. Now that we've learned a bunch of different strategies, and also we've done a few together, let's see if you can solve these on your own. You can choose whatever strategy works best for you. Remember, you can pause this video in case you need more time.
4/8 or 2/8? 4/8 is greater than 2/8. 2/6 or 6/10? 2/6 is less than 6/10. 2/3 or 3/6? 2/3 is greater than 3/6.
How'd you do? Did you get them all correct? What strategy is your favorite? Do you need other videos talking about fractions? Check out our other videos on our channel. We also put new videos out every month, so make sure you're subscribed. Bye!